Before you actually start memorizing in a memory competition, it's a good idea to warm up your mind. So I want to share some things I do to warm up my mind. So the first thing I focus on are my memory systems. Because if you're slow on your memory systems, then you're going to be slow when it comes to memorizing information. So let's say I'm going through cards. So the first time I might do people, second time action, third time object. That's because I have a PAO. Now, if I mess up any time during recalling my images, what I'm going to do is redo that. So what I mean is, if I'm going through this and I'm trying to recall my people and I'm like, okay, that's Dorothy, but I say that's Darth Vader, guess what? I'm doing it again until I get every single card right the first time. So when it came to the French Open, my binary system was my weakest system. So I spent a lot of time practicing my binary system before I actually started the competition, because I want to make sure that I was reading the binary correctly and getting the correct image. And so I just want to make sure that I could do it multiple times, get everything 100% right. And then when I actually did the event, it wasn't too bad considering that I didn't train at all. So that warm up really helped me when it came to the actual memory event. Now, another thing you want to start to practice before a memory competition, right before the event, are your palaces and journeys. Because if these are slow as well, you're going to have a hard time. And if they're fuzzy, man, you're really going to struggle. And so you want to plan everything out, you know, not the day of, but actually like a couple days before. You want to have, you know, these set for cards, these ones for binary, and so on. And so right before the competition starts, you go through all of the palaces just to make sure every single location is there. Now, I used to tally everything. So when I went through my home journey, I would tally every single location I was seeing in my head. And then hopefully when I looked at the tallies, there was 26, right? And so I don't do that for palaces I really, really have down. But for new palaces that I'm not really quite familiar with, I do that just to make sure I have all the locations that I'm supposed to have for that specific palace. You might want to do the same. But another thing you want to be able to do is, for binary, I use two palaces to memorize that one trial. And so I jump from one palace to another. So when I go through my palaces, I'm like, okay, so I'm going through the first palace, boom, the second palace starts there, and it was a smooth transition. Because if you don't have that, you might finish your first palace and you're like, oh crap, what was the second palace? Now you're freaking out because you have to try to find a memory palace so you can continue memorizing the information, right? And so you want to make sure that you're able to go through any palaces you might have to jump to. So that is good to do before an event even. But also, probably the best time is to do it right before competition and then do a quick review right before the event just to double make sure you're able to go from the first palace to the second palace, maybe even to the third palace. And this is something that's really true for like our cards, because you have all these decks of cards you're memorizing, right? And so you're going from the first palace to the second palace to the third palace. And so having that order is necessary, because if you start mixing stuff up, you're going to start screwing yourself up when you actually start memorizing the deck of cards and then start to recall the decks. And so it's just better to kind of review all this stuff in the beginning. And those are the two things I mainly do before a competition, my palaces and my different memory systems. I don't do any memorizations of the actual information. Like, I don't do a trial for cards, numbers, or anything like that, because I don't want to mix any of those images I create with any of the images I create during the actual events. Because even though they might be different, I might for some reason start thinking, oh yeah, you know, I saw this person in the practice trial and I see the same person in the actual memorization, and I might for some reason start printing down the information from that other event just because I'm like, oh yeah, hey, that's similar. So just to kind of get rid of that, I just don't memorize before the competition, because I don't want anything to screw me up. And so if I avoid all of that, then for sure I won't have any mixed information coming from different trials. So yeah, so that's how I warm up my mind before memory competition. There's probably some other things people do too. If this is something that you do or think would be useful, let me know. But hopefully you enjoy this video, and I'll see you next time.